DFS is frequently used algorithm in trees and graph.
Depth first search problems are usually solved using stack. Let's start with this simple example here. Print all the characters in a string using a for loop. It's trivial. You can just use a for loop and you can print all the characters, right? Let's move on. Okay, now let's see the same example using recursion. Okay, here my print takes two param. First param is string, second is index. The first step is validation, or the base case for the recursive call, where we will check if str is null or index I is greater than or equal to length of the string, then we will return. Second step is print as usual, print the character using the current index. And third one is calling the myPrint method again, passing string and the next index. You see, we are calling the myPrint method again, right? Which means we are actually pushing the myPrint method to the call stack, right? Now let's see how this method looks like when we are using a stack. So right here you can see I am using a stack where I am pushing the index. Yeah, so take a note, string is not changing here. We don't have to push that into our stack. Now start a while loop. Immediately after the while loop, we pop this stack and assign that value to I. The first step is validation, right? Which is our base case. And the second step is printing the character, and the third step is push the next index to the stack, right? In the third step, we call the recursive method. Instead, right now, we will push the param into the stack. If you run this program, the while loop will continue until the stack is empty. Yeah. Now let's see this example, okay, where we are using a linked list and we are printing all the numbers in the linked list using recursion. Linked list is not very different than the array, right? The only difference is it has a next element and the next element points to the next node. If you see this solution, my print now will take the list node as the param. So now the first step, which is nothing but the validation or the base case for our recursive solution, if node equal to null, then return, right? Second step is, yes, we have to print the value of the node. That's what we are doing here. And in the third step, we'll call the myPrint again for the next node. Does it make sense? I think you can now write the iterative approach for this solution using a stack. Let's move on. Okay. So far we have dealt with all the linear data structure, right? We covered array and linked list, which are linear data structure, right? But tree and graph are in fact non-linear in nature. One particular node can be connected to more than one nodes. That's why they are called non-linear. Okay. Take this example of an array tree. Each node can be connected to multiple children. So the structure may look like this: class tree node with a int value and with a children array. Right. Now let's think about how can we print the values for this n array tree. In a linear data structure, each node was connected to only one node. That's why we were using next, or we are using a index. Here, because each node is connected to multiple children, so what we have to do, we just have to call the myPrint method in a for loop in our third step. That's it. First and second step does not change. I hope that you will be able to write the iterative solution using a stack. Any of this approach, this recursive or the iterative approach, we are using a stack. So the space complexity is not going to change. This is what I want to say. DFS is nothing but using the recursive approach to solve a tree or a graph problem. And the core of the logic is, you might have already observed that we are actually doing only three steps in any recursive call here. The first is validation or the base case, where we do some validation or we check the base case for which the recursive solution will stop. And the second step is process the node. We might print, or we might write to a different file, or we might do some other operation. And the third step is recurse or push the connected nodes again to the stack.
I will also be covering tree and graph problem from LeetCode using these techniques. So pay a very close attention to these three techniques.
So remember, while dealing with graphs, we just have to take care of one thing, that we are not visiting the same node again, because graphs can have cycle. So in the case of graph, in the second step, put that node into a set or a hash map and say that it is visited in the interview. Do not try to write the stack approach unless the interviewer asks you. In the interview, you are free to use any of the approach, but I think the recursive approach is simpler to write.
While solving a problem, so pay close attention to the steps that I take. And I also mention about some of the homework. Please do that. That will help you in competitive programming. Three simple steps. If you like this content, like, share, subscribe, and comment below.